And the correct answer, if you remember right from the last unit, is that we need to take some NP-complete problem and show that we can use shortest tour to solve that problem. So this one up here is correct. Because as I told you, a reduction basically means that we show that this NP-complete problem here, and we still have to choose a good one, kind of fits into shortest tour. So shortest tour is at least as hard to solve as this one up here. If it were the other way around, then you would just show that this NP-complete problem is at least as hard to solve as shortest tour, but that doesn't give you any statement about shortest tour. So this is the way we need to do the reduction. Now it says some complete NP problem here. So the question, of course, is which one is it going to be? And later in this unit, I'm going to show you a bunch of resources that you can use to find suitable NP-complete problems to do your reduction. Because when you have a very similar problem, and that's what you've seen with vertex cover and independent set, then the reduction becomes much easier to do. And we saw with SAT and click, for example, that if you have problems that are a bit different, then you might run into trouble. So I'll give you those resources, but here's a general rule. If you don't find an NP-complete problem that is very similar to the one where you're trying to prove that it is NP-complete, then usually it's a good idea to start with SAT, because SAT is a very, well, in a way, very flexible and very universal NP-complete problem. So that's exactly what we're going to do here as well. We're going to try to reduce SAT to shortest tour.